Yo, I know what you're gonna say. Like, Chris, people listen to you. Every season is annoying. And to you people, I say yes. Every season is annoying. Hi everyone, my name is Christina, and to you I present the first reason why spring is annoying. Because I keep on buying plants and they keep on dying. And yes, I blame spring for it. So you wanna know what other things I blame on spring? First, allergies. There is no need for me to talk about this all over again. I made a whole video about it.
Thank you, suggestion bud.
This video is generally divided into two categories. Category 1 is my biological struggles. And then there's category number 2, which is peer pressure. You better have something to say about it. And peer pressure number 1 is to change your wardrobe. And no. This isn't just a peer pressure, it's the need to change everything about your look. Because apparently winter, the magical season with no heat, no gym, no waxing, no allergies, yep, that's still an issue, is way too depressing. So all the girls be like, when I'm just over here like, nothing has changed, I'm still my dark self, and you are still a mess of a person you were before the 1st of March. Reality sucks. All of a sudden, for no sane reason, I have to wear lighter colors, skirts and dresses, and I'm not having it. Please make this a meme. I'm not having it. So all of a sudden, for no apparent reason, I have to wear lighter colors, skirts and dresses, and I'm not having it, because I don't have time to go walk or to buy a new razor, so... Can you tell I went to a yoga class? Oh, that was hard. Your pressure number 2 is getting a boyfriend. Breathe in, breathe out, baby. So people say that spring is a season of love. And for you, I have 2 things to say. A. If spring is a season of love, then why the hell is St. Valentine's Day in February? And B. Is that I'm not a cat to start mating in March. Also, I feel a need to make a final remark about PDA. I get that you're in love, and it's totally fine to show that in public. As long as I don't have to teach sex ed to my younger sister, just from looking at the two of you on the freaking bench. Now that that is out of my system, another stupid slash annoying thing about spring is spring photoshoot. Bear with me here, I'll explain. So, I'm a person with a camera. Pretty obvious, right? And in the mind of 90% of girls, person plus camera equals a photographer. Like, even a camera on your more advanced iPhone makes you a photographer. You know where I'm going with this, right? It's because girls, as sneaky as little bastards, they won't come up to you and be like, "Hi, I want to make a new profile pic. Can you help me out?" No, this is just way too obvious. So instead, they'll be like, "Hey, isn't the weather great today?" Yeah, the weather is perfect for a walk, you know, you and I in the park. We'll have some coffee, make some ice cream, you know? You have camera on you, right?
I do. All the time.
Look, it's just so sunny. This camera is just asking for a picture. You know how to use Photoshop, right?
This is the reason why I stopped taking good photos. I can be confronted if I choose to. I just don't want to be enslaved to making your new profile pictures and Instagram posts till the day that I die. Honestly, there are so many reasons why spring is annoying. Like the fact that it's sunny outside and I still have to wear my winter coat because hello Ukraine and climate change. Or romantic novels being on sale. Why the hell are dystopian novels never on sale? Is the government trying to dumb me down? On the other hand, tender is the night. That was surprisingly good.
It's the positive outro I didn't expect, because you know, I had to make up for all the terrible things that were said about spring. If you feel the same way about this season as I did, please give this video a thumbs up.
Also, tell me in the comments down below what's the best thing about spring. To me, these are flowers, so I'm not allergic to anything. On that note, I wish you had the spring. Bye-bye!
And I broke a flower.
I broke a flower, I'm a fucking loser.